Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Celebrity Net Worth. On this episode, we will be going over 50 Cent's net worth. Make sure to stay till the end of this video to find out how much this celebrity's worth. If you're new to this channel or if you haven't done so yet, make sure to hit that subscribe button and smash the like button. In this video, we will be talking about a rapper. He is none other than 50 Cent. Being such a well-known rapper in the industry, he surely is making a large sum of cash. How much do you think his net worth is? We will later reveal his net worth after getting to know him a little. Let's get to it. Curtis James Jackson III, better known by his stage name 50 Cent, is an American rapper, actor, producer, and entrepreneur. He was born July 6, 1975 in the South Jamaica neighborhood of the borough of Queens, New York City by his mother Sabrina. A drug dealer, Sabrina raised Jackson until she died in a mysterious fire when Jackson was 8. After his mother's death and father's departure, Jackson was raised by his grandmother. He began boxing at about age 11, and when he was 14, a neighbor opened a boxing gym for local youth. At age 12, Jackson began dealing narcotics when his grandparents thought he was in after-school programs and brought guns and drug money to school. In the 10th grade, he was caught by metal detectors at Andrew Jackson High School. On June 29, 1994, Jackson was arrested for selling 4 vials of cocaine to an undercover police officer. He was arrested again 3 weeks later when police searched his home and found heroin, 10 ounces of crack cocaine, and a starting pistol. Although Jackson was sentenced to 3 to 9 years in prison, he served 6 months in a boot camp and earned his GED. He has said that he did not use cocaine himself. Jackson adopted the name 50 Cent as a metaphor for the change. The name was inspired by Kelvin Martin, a 1980s Brooklyn robber known as 50 Cent. He later began pursuing a musical career, and in 2000, he produced Power of the Dollar for Columbia Records. But days before the planned release, he was shot and the album was never released. In 2002, after Jackson released the compilation album Guess Who's Back, he was discovered by Eminem and signed to Shady Records under the aegis of Dr. Dre's Aftermath Entertainment and Interscope Records as part of a $1 million deal. With the aid of Eminem and Dr. Dre, who produced his first major label album, Get Rich or Die Tryin', Jackson became one of the world's best-selling rappers and rose to prominence with East Coast hip-hop group G-Unit. In 2003, he founded G-Unit Records, signing his G-Unit associates Young Buck, Lloyd Banks, and Tony Yayo. Jackson had similar commercial and critical success with his second album, The Massacre, which was released in 2005. He released his 5th studio album, Animal Ambition, in 2014, and as of 2019 is working on his 6th studio album, Street King Immortal. He executive produces and stars in the show Power, which airs on Stars. During his career, Jackson has sold over 30 million albums worldwide and won several awards, including a Grammy Award, 13 Billboard Music Awards, 6 World Music Awards, 3 American Music Awards, and 4 BET Awards. He has pursued an acting career, appearing in the semi-autobiographical film Get Rich or Die Tryin' 2005, the Iraq War film Home of the Brave 2006, and Righteous Kill 2008. 50 Cent was ranked 6th best artist of the 2000s and the 3rd best rapper behind Eminem and Nelly by Billboard. Rolling Stone ranked Get Rich or Die Tryin' and In Da Club in its list of 100 best albums of the 2000s and 100 best songs of the 2000s at number 37 and 13 respectively. Jackson has had a highly successful business career. He is financially invested in a highly diversified variety of industries. Jackson is now involved in artist and talent management, record, television, and film production, footwear, apparel, fragrances, liquor, video games, mobile apps, book publishing, headphones, and health drinks and dietary supplements. His broad business and investment portfolio contain business ventures investments in a variety of sectors, including real estate, financial market investments, mining, boxing promotion, vodka, fragrances, consumer electronics, and fashion. He established his own record label, G-Unit Records, in 2003 following his mainstream success. In November 2003, he signed a 5-year deal with Reebok to distribute a G-Unit sneakers line for his G-Unit clothing company. After becoming a minority shareholder and celebrity spokesperson, Jackson worked with the company to create a new grape-flavored Formula 50 variant of vitamin water and mentioned the drinks in various songs and interviews. In 2007, Coca-Cola purchased Glassau for $4.1 billion and, according to Forbes, Jackson, who was a minority shareholder, earned $100 million from the deal after taxes. Though he no longer has an equity stake in the company, Jackson continues to act as a spokesperson for Vitamin Water, supporting the product, including singing about it at the BET Awards, and expressing his excitement over the company's continuing to allow his input on products. He joined RightGuard to introduce a body spray, Pure 50 RGX, and endorsed Magic Stick condoms, planning to donate part of their proceeds to increasing HIV awareness. Jackson signed a multi-year deal with Steiner Sports to sell his memorabilia and announced plans for a dietary supplement company in conjunction with his film Spectacular Regret in August 2007. Jackson has founded two film production companies, G-Unit Films in 2003 and Cheetahvision in 2008. Cheetahvision produces low-budget action thrillers for foreign film markets across the world. When G-Unit Films folded, he focused on Cheetahvision and the company obtained $200 million in funding in 2010. In 2010, Jackson revived G-Unit Films, renaming the company to G-Unit Films and Television Incorporated. The company has joint ventures with Will Packer's production company, Will Packer Productions, and Universal Television. In over 18 months, Jackson has sold projects to six different networks. Among them was Power, a Starz drama, in which he not only co-stars, but also serves as a co-creator and executive producer. Power debuted in June 2014 and was renewed for a second season after one episode. Jackson became a minority shareholder in FN Vodka, a brand of vodka produced in the Netherlands, when he invested an undisclosed amount in the company Sire Spirits LLC. He currently endorses the product via his live concert performances and social media. The rapper was asked to take part in two promotional bottle signings, one in Oak Creek and the other in Sun Prairie. Jackson made an appearance at Liquor Warehouse in Syracuse, New York on April 25, 2015, where he reportedly sold 1,400 bottles, 277 gallons, of Jackson's signature brand. Liquor Warehouse's owner George Angeloro reportedly stocked 300 cases, 1,800 bottles or 357 gallons, of FN Vodka, which sells for $30 a bottle prior to the event. In December 2014, Jackson signed a $78 million deal with Frigo Revolution Wear, a luxury underwear brand. The joint venture is partnered between Jackson, basketball player Carmelo Anthony, baseball player Derek Jeter, and Matthias Ingvarsson, the former president of mattress company Tempur-Pedic. 50 Cent is perhaps one of the best-known names in the music industry right now. However, recently the rapper has been making headlines due to his financial woes. The performer recently filed for bankruptcy, much to the surprise of fans from around the globe. After so many successful albums and profitable ventures, the bankruptcy came as a shock. It is estimated that before filing for bankruptcy in the summer of 2015, Mr. Jackson had taken in $3.3 million in royalties and advances that year alone. He has listed his monthly income at nearly $184,969, most of which comes from his G-Unit branded entertainment deals in music, film, and television. Forbes has estimated that his total net worth is $155 million, and he was once named as one of hip-hop's future billionaires by the company. As for his assets, when the bankruptcy was filed, it was estimated that they were at $24,823,899.18. In 2009, Listonia Leviston sued 50 Cent for allegedly uploading a stolen sex tape to his website, which featured his then-rival Rick Ross's intimate moments with Leviston. In July of 2015, she won, and 50 Cent was ordered to pay her $7 million. His feud with Ross hasn't ended, though it appears his feud with Leviston may have. As the decade changed and 50 Cent made more money, it seems more problems follow. One day in 2016, a producer, Brandon Parrott, alleged Dr. Dre and 50 Cent used a beat of his for the Get Rich or Die Tryin' song, PIMP. Parrott sued both artists, about 13 years after the first hit brought 50 Cent to hip-hop fame. As one might imagine, lawsuits over such intellectual property disputes are not uncommon, particularly in hip-hop, but the PIMP lawsuit was dropped the same year it was filed by Parrott in 2016. In 2018, he was sued, along with Akbar Abdul Ahad, by Tayara Marie for allegedly planning to sexually objectify, threaten, intimidate, humiliate, and degrade her. Abdul Ahad was her ex-boyfriend. She claimed he logged into her Instagram account and posted a sexually graphic video that featured ejaculate on her face. Marie said after she removed the video and photo posted by her ex-boyfriend, 50 Cent posted the material on his own page. 50 Cent denied the allegations, and a judge sided with him, ordering her to pay him $30,000 for filing a frivolous lawsuit, and also ordered her to pay him extra sanctions of $4,392.50 for not paying him in a timely manner. In 2015, 50 Cent declared Chapter 11 bankruptcy to have time to reorganize his business interests and expenses. He was ordered the following year by the bankruptcy court in Connecticut, where he lived, to pay creditors $23 million over 5 years. He paid it off after a few months, helped by a settlement in his favor from another case. He sold his Connecticut mansion that same year for an estimated $8 million. 50 Cent had bought the mansion from Mike Tyson, the boxer, in 2003. Before selling the home of the former world heavyweight boxing champion, 50 Cent spent $70 a month to maintain three homes. The former Tyson mansion, which had 21 bedrooms, an 8-car garage, a racquetball court, and a home movie theater, was 50 Cent's main home. 50 Cent paid $4.1 million for the property, then spent an additional $6 million on various upgrades, including adding a private movie theater, infinity pool, and a helicopter pad. Besides homes, 50 Cent had a fleet of expensive vehicles which are estimated at a total of $500,000. Among his vehicles are a 1966 Chevrolet Coupe, a 2015 Chevrolet Suburban, a Rolls-Royce Phantom, a 2005 Chevrolet Suburban, a 2008 Dodge Sprinter, a 2003 Chevrolet Suburban, and a 2012 Suzuki Kizashi Sport. It is also reported that 50 Cent owns the White Lightning concept car, one of the fastest electric cars ever produced. It reportedly can reach speeds of 250 miles an hour. It costs $1.55 million to produce. In addition to spending on homes and vehicles, 50 Cent also owed $855,091 in child support to ex-girlfriend Daphne Narvaez, according to his bankruptcy documents. He also has other properties, including investment properties in Atlanta and Long Island, and a New Jersey apartment that the rapper leases. In total, he spends around $700,000 a month to maintain his three homes alone. We will now reveal his net worth. But before that, don't forget to comment below which celebrity you'd like to see next time on Celebrity Net Worth. 50 Cent's net worth is $30 million. That's all for rapper 50 Cent. See you in the next video.